Hello and welcome back, everybody. J-Man here for some more music reactions. I hope you're all doing well out there, staying safe, staying connected. So we have another warning request. This is from Daniel H86 again. Sorry, sneeze. basically we've been working our way through their newest album or LP that they released. I've been enjoying it quite a bit, despite the heck that I seem to be getting from the diehard Warning fans. Last video, I wasn't quite sure exactly who was doing the vocals. I was pretty sure it was Powell, but I couldn't make up my mind and caught some crap for that. But everybody has to remember that I don't listen to the Warning on the regular. While I am a fan of their music, they're not somebody that I've got on playlists that I listen to and things like that. That's not because I don't like them enough. I just have not added them to any of my playlists. Actually, lately I've been listening to just randomly generated playlists off of YouTube. So please forgive me if I'm not able to pick up or discern exactly who's doing the vocals. Like I said, I do know that there's that little phrasing thing that Pow tends to do at the end of her phrases. That's how I usually tell that it's her. Anyways, cut me a little slack if you would, please. Let's go ahead. Let's dive on in. The Warning 23. Let's get it.
I looked at you same as before. What had changed, I do not know.
This is Dan.
The thought of you replayed in secret. It hurt me, but I asked for more. Falling down your rabbit hole, I kept on biting back what I was feeling. I closed my eyes and you were there. Innocently unaware. Stop me, stop me. Tell me, tell me. Break my heart for all I care. As long as I get to be there. Stop me, stop me. Tell me, is it wrong?
Or is it? Now I'm questioning myself again. I think now I'm thinking it's Bow. I'm wondering if they're both in here. Okay, quick pause here to get my first impression. So, yeah, I'm really digging the direction that they've gone here with this new album. There were a couple of songs, and I caught some flack for that as well, where I said I felt like maybe there was a song or two that was a little formulaic. Not that they were bad, just nothing super newer interesting in them that I was finding. But this pretty much everyone that I've heard off of this new album, it all has a different bit of a flair to it. And I'm really enjoying that. Again, I'm not 100% sure where the vocals are coming from, if they're Danny or Pow or both of them. There were points when I thought I heard both of their voices. And I know that they do provide backup vocals for each other and things like that. But regardless, I am enjoying the vocal. And I love, for as young as they are, I love their lyric writing. There's a wisdom or an age beyond their years in their lyrics that I just find absolutely fascinating. And it's also got that little hint of kind of a cryptic message going on, which I feel is the best lyrical content that you get from rock music. It's somewhat hidden, or there's a little bit of a hidden meaning. They're not coming right out and saying, you know, it's not like country music where you're telling a story and what's being done lyrically is obvious and in your face. And it opens it up for interpretation and things like that. You know, there are so many rock and metal songs that can mean one thing to one person and another to another person. And I feel like there is definitely a large sense of that in the Warnings music, and I love that. So yeah, enjoying this a lot. Let's back it up a smidge and we'll keep on going. Talking about the drums there. All right. Yeah, very good. I really like that one. I think that might be, well, there was that first one that we listened to that was Pow, that I did really enjoy. The one that we listened to last time, thank you to whoever it was that gave me a little bit of the information on that song that somebody said that that piano song that Pow did, the last one we reacted to, was sort of just like a fill-in song. The label wanted one more song for the album. Excuse me, sorry. The label wanted one more song, and Pal had this song that she had done, and she agreed to go ahead and add it to the album as long as they didn't ask her to play it live. Something to that effect. Forgive me if I'm getting all of the details wrong. But I did enjoy that, but I think this may be my favorite. There was something about the chord progressions and just the general tune and tone of the song that was very cool, very different from anything that I've heard from The Warning, and not like readily reminiscent to me of any other artist or anything. With as old as I am and having heard as much music as I have, being a fan of all kinds of different genres and stuff, I have this thing where a lot of songs, it's like, oh, that sounds a little like this song or a little like this band or whatever. This didn't bring any of that to the forefront for me. It sounded, uniquely The Warning, and that's very cool. I enjoy that. So, yeah, very good stuff. Thanks so much for the request, Daniel. I hope you enjoyed the reaction. Those of you on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed it as well. Let me know what you thought down in the comments below. We'll be back for a couple more music reactions for the day here. I hope to see you for those. But till we see you next, stay safe. Peace.